a very, very contentious debate, some of the most important issues facing the country right now. But Jake Tapper, clearly the headline, Donald Trump saying he may not accept the result of this presidential election.
One of the most stunning things I've ever heard in a presidential debate ever. And while I think it's fair to say that he had some decent moments in there, especially when he was criticizing Obama and Clinton on foreign policy, the big hurdle for Donald Trump was, will he show the country that he has the temperament, that he has what it takes, that he has the fitness to be president? And to say that he, to suggest that he might not accept the results of the election that we're about to hold in fewer than 3 weeks was staggering. And I don't think it helped him when it comes to showing the American people that he does have that temperament. The one thing I was looking for in this debate is, would he do anything to turn around the momentum? All the college-educated whites that are going to Hillary Clinton, all the women that are going to Hillary Clinton, all the minorities that are going to Hillary Clinton. No, I don't think he did anything to turn that around. Yes, he had some good moments, especially when it came to criticisms of her and her policies and President Obama's policies. But to suggest that he is not going to necessarily accept the results of the nomination, that was a disastrous answer.
Yeah, it was truly extraordinary. I've never heard anything like that. Dana Bash, his vice presidential running mate, said that they, of course, would accept the result, the voice of the American people. His daughter said the same thing. He refused to say that. He said, I want to keep you in suspense.
Not only did his running mate say that, he said that to us in that very debate hall about an hour before Donald Trump took the stage. So it really goes to show that Donald Trump, no matter how much he prepared, and we do understand he prepared very well, and for the most part, as Jake said, I agree with you, Jake, that for the most part during this debate, that came through, that he was a much more disciplined Donald Trump. And I think at the end of the day, before that comment happened, it looked like it was a wash. That she did well, that he did well, that it wasn't really, really clear if anybody was going to benefit or not until that moment when he was asked something very basic, something that my understanding is that he was certainly prepared for, and he didn't answer it in affirmatively. And more importantly, she was prepared for it. She had all of her opposition research ready to go about the times where he called other systems rigged, even the Emmys, when he didn't win an Emmy. Wolf.
She clearly was ready for that. John King, did either one of them move the needle tonight?
Not in a significant way, I don't think. If you remember, talk about this where we come in. Hillary Clinton has a significant advantage in our electoral map, over 300 electoral votes. We have her 307. Donald Trump in the 170s, well short of the 270 you need to win. So you think, okay, 19 days left. Did he have this, with the biggest audience they're going to get before Election Day, did he do anything to move the dial in the way he needs to move it? He needs to bend steel to change this election. He's right now, we've taken Utah away from him and Arizona to make them toss-up states. At the beginning, when he was talking about judges, when he's talking about guns, when he's talking about abortion, at the top of the debate, very base-driven to the Republicans, it is possible he boosted his support among Republicans with those answers. But to the point Jake and Dana are making, I was getting emails from Republicans in the key swing states, in New Hampshire, in Ohio, in Florida. In all three states, the reactions are essentially, I'm going to say, oh, my God. They were not that polite when Donald Trump refused to say he would accept the results of the election. They think that a man who had such a good gut for Republicans during the primary does not have a gut that middle America wants him to respect the process.
One other thing that I thought was a really important moment, Chris Wallace asked Donald Trump about the allegations of sexual assault and sexual attention that was not wanted, and put a tough question to Hillary Clinton about, he says, what your husband, Bill Clinton, has done is even worse. Donald Trump attacked the women that have accused him, suggested that they were liars and put up to it by the Clinton campaign. Hillary Clinton gave a very passionate speech that was speaking to all women. All women know what it's like to be belittled like this. Completely dodged the question about Bill Clinton. Back to Trump, he's defending himself again. He's not even pointing out that Hillary Clinton, who gave this very passionate speech with this really uncomfortable asterisk there, which is, how can you say that when these allegations have been made against your husband? And he just whiffed it. He just completely let it go because he is so focused on defending himself, he couldn't even see clearly to then prosecute Hillary Clinton on what I thought was probably her strongest moment.
I also think at that point of the debate, she was under a scare.